Hello guys, welcome to Unext Officer channel. I am Dr. Adhira and in this channel I will be teaching you important topics of biology which are repeatedly asked in several central exams. If you haven't subscribed this channel then please do subscribe this channel. Today's episode we are going to discuss about an important topic, that is vitamins and minerals. First about vitamins. Mainly vitamins are classified as fat soluble vitamins and water soluble vitamins. Among them, vitamin A, D, E and K are the fat soluble vitamins and the rest are water soluble vitamins. Now firstly we will just look into the chemical names of each vitamins and the sources of important vitamins. First about vitamin A. The chemical name of vitamin A is retinol. And the richest source of vitamin A is green leafy vegetables and carrot. Vitamin D is called calciferol and it is produced in our skin directly with the help of sunlight. The active form of vitamin D is called calcitriol. Vitamin E is called tocopherol and the richest source of vitamin E is sunflower seeds. Vitamin K is called phylloquinin. Vitamin B1 is called thiamine. Vitamin B2 is called riboflavin. Vitamin B3 is called niacin. Vitamin B5 is called pantothenic acid. Vitamin B6 is called pyridoxine. Vitamin B7 is called biotin. And guys, it is important to note that egg whites contain a protein called avidin which prevents the absorption of biotin. Vitamin B9 is called folic acid. Vitamin B12 is called cyanocobalamin and vitamin C is called ascorbic acid. The richest source of vitamin C is amla and the citrus fruits like orange and lemon are also rich sources of vitamin C. Okay, now let's study about the deficiency disease of each in detail caused by each of these vitamins. First about vitamin A. Vitamin A deficiency, that is retinol deficiency, causes a spectrum of disease called xerophthalmia, which includes night blindness, that is difficulty in vision in dim light, bitoid spots, which are white triangular spots of conjunctiva, and keratomalacia, which is a dryness of cornea. So vitamin A is a spectrum of disease that contains, which is called xerophthalmia, which includes night blindness, bitoid spots, and keratomalacia. Now about the vitamin B1. Vitamin B1 deficiency or thiamine deficiency causes a disease called beriberi. And the beriberi is of two types. Wet beriberi involves cardiovascular system and dry beriberi involves nervous system. And it is important to note that thiamine deficiency is mainly seen in alcoholics and in them it causes Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome. A Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome is characterized by confusion, amnesia, vision changes, double vision, and there will be loss of muscle coordination, which is called ataxia. So that's about the thiamine deficiency. Now about vitamin B2 or riboflavin deficiency. It causes a disease called riboflavinosis. Arabinoflavinosis is characterized by chelosis and angular stomatitis. The chelosis is dry lips and angular stomatitis is a lesion at the corner of the mouth. Vitamin B3 deficiency, that is niacin deficiency, causes pellagra. And pellagra is characterized by 3D. They are dermatitis, dementia and diarrhea. Now about vitamin B5 or pantothenic acid deficiency. It causes paresthesia as it involves nervous system. Vitamin B6 or pyridoxine deficiency is characterized by anemia and peripheral neuropathy. Pyridoxine deficiency is commonly caused by a drug given for the treatment of tuberculosis, that is isoniazid. So in patients for whom we start an anti-tubercular therapy, pyridoxine is given along with isoniazid. विटामिन B9 डेफिशिएंसी और फोलिक एसिड डेफिशिएंसी ऑल्सो कॉसेस मेगालोब्लास्टिक एनीमिया. Now it is important to note that vitamin B9 or folic acid deficiency in pregnancy is associated with a birth defect called neural tube defect, which includes diseases like spina bifida and anencephaly. So it is important to supplement women with folic acid ideally even before conception. Routinely, pregnant women are given 0.5 mg of folic acid daily during their pregnancy. But women who are on anti-seizure drugs or for women who have previous history of neural tube defects, since they are of high risk, a higher dose of folic acid is given. That is 5 milligram of folic acid is given for them. So that's about the folic acid deficiency. Now about the vitamin B12 or cyanocobalamin deficiency. This cyanocobalamin deficiency, also like the folic acid deficiency, causes megaloblastic anemia, which is characterized by large sized RBC. It is important to note that vitamin B12 deficiency are usually seen in people who follow strict vegetarian diet. Now, vitamin C deficiency or ascorbic acid deficiency is called scurvy. Scurvy is characterized by bleeding gums, easy bruising, and red rashes over the body can also be seen. Bone changes are also seen associated with scurvy, and this bone changes is called scorbutic rosacea. About the vitamin D deficiency or cholecalciferol deficiency, they causes rickets in children and osteomalacia in adults. Vitamin D is needed for the absorption of calcium. So in vitamin D deficiency, there will be decreased calcium in the bone, and this will lead to weak bones. Bone changes seen in rickets is called rachitic rosacea. In children with rickets, there will be delayed growth and there will be deformity of the chest and rib. Bow legs can be seen, and deformity of the skull can also be seen. In adults, due to this decrease in bone strength due to deficiency of calcium, these adults will be more susceptible for fractures, and bone pain can also be seen. About vitamin E deficiency or tocopherol deficiency, vitamin E and tocopherol is needed for maintaining the lining epithelium of the reproductive tract, and vitamin E is also an antioxidant. So in its deficiency, it will lead to sterility. But it is important to note that its deficiency is very rare, and it is also associated with mild hemolytic anemia in newborn infants. Now, about the vitamin K or phylloquinone deficiency. Vitamin K is needed for clotting to occur. So in its deficiency, there will be defective clotting, and increased clotting time will be seen. It is vitamin K deficiency, there will be hemophilia disorder. Hemophilia is characterized by bleeding into joints, and red patches due to bleeding beneath the skin can be seen, which are called ecchymosis. Now about anemia. Guys, you all know that iron is needed for the production of hemoglobin. So in iron deficiency, hemoglobin level will be decreased. The role of hemoglobin is to deliver oxygen to body parts, and in its deficiency causes anemia, which is characterized by fatigue due to decreased oxygen supply, and there will be visible paleness of the palm and lower eyelid. This is called pallor. In children, hookworm infestation is an important cause of anemia. Now about the iodine. Iodine is needed for the thyroxine hormone synthesis. So in its deficiency, thyroid gland will have to work overload, and it will be resulting in thyroid enlargement, which will be clinically visible, and this is called goiter. As this disease, this goiter will be associated with decrease in thyroid hormone level, and this decrease in thyroid hormone level is called hypothyroidism. In hypothyroidism, there will be unexpected weight gain, fatigue, cold intolerance, and decreased heart rate will be seen. Now, potassium is an important mineral in blood. If the decreased potassium level in blood is called hypokalemia, and it is characterized by muscle paralysis, decreased bowel movements, and change in heart rate. Whereas increase in potassium in blood is called hyperkalemia, and it is also characterized by changes in the heart rate. And hyperkalemia is more commonly seen in patients with renal failure. So that's all about the important vitamins and minerals. Now for revision sake, guys, what do vitamin A deficiency causes? Yes, vitamin A deficiency causes a spectrum of disorder called xerophthalmia, which is consists of night blindness, bitter spot, and keratomalacia. Now, what is riboflavinosis? Riboflavinosis is seen in riboflavin deficiency or vitamin B2 deficiency, and it is characterized by chelosis and angular stomatitis. Chelosis is dryness or cracking of the lips, and angular stomatitis is characterized by lesions around the corners of the mouth. Now, what is pellagra? Pellagra is due to deficiency of niacin, and it is characterized by 3D, dermatitis, dementia, and diarrhea. So, guys, hope you all are thorough with this topic now, and let's meet in the next video with another topic. Till then, bye.